हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टुडेज धन की बात। अगेन लेट्स स्टार्ट दी टुडेज एनालिसिस विद निफ्टी। अगेन निफ्टी हैज़ बीन सीन अ वेरी गुड ट्रैक्शन इन द लास्ट वीक एंड अगेन इट मैनेज टू क्लोज ऑन द पॉजिटिव वीक। सो आई थिंक गोइंग फॉरवर्ड वेयर वन शुड लुक फॉर नाउ, इफ यू लुक एट ऑन द 2 hourly चार्ट दैट वन नीड टू लुक फॉर द सपोर्ट इफ सो दे नीड टू लुक ऑन द आवरली चार्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल। नाउ इफ यू कैन सीन हियर it is trading in the rising channel, one can say it is trading in the rising channel. So I think the immediate support coming somewhere for the Nifty is 15,600, which is the immediate support, and the trend changing level will be this level, okay, which is 15,470, 15,450. So until unless we are trading above, let's say 15,450 on the positional perspective, the structure will be positive. We may see some dips, but again that dips can be used as the buying opportunity with keeping overall stop loss below 15,450. Below 15,450, we may see some trend reversal. Okay, so 15,450 is very important level to watch on the downside. We don't hold below 15,450. So this will be the final stop loss for the longs. If you are holding on the positional perspective, your final stop loss will be 15,450. That would be a trend deciding level. Now on the higher side, immediate hurdle is placed at 15,800 and 16,000. So on the immediate basis, 15,800 call has been seen the writing, and 16,000 call also has been seen the writing. So I think these are the immediate hurdle, one can say, on the higher side. So on the immediate basis, 15,800, 16,000 will be hurdle. On immediate basis, 15,600 will be immediate support, and the overall support lies at 15,470, 15,450 odd levels. Below that, we may see some train reversal signals. Okay, so that's the view for the Nifty. Now let's look at the Nifty Bank also. Now if you can see Nifty Bank, these are the resistors that we discussed in the last week also, and from there we have been witnessed some sort of profit booking, but I think the overall structure is still positive until unless we are trading somewhere about 35,000 on the immediate basis and 34,400 on the overall basis. So these are the strong support on the downside. If one can ask what are the Nifty Bank support? So 35,000 will be first support, 34,400 will be the final support for the Nifty Bank, and unless we are trading above mentioned support, the structure is positive, and we may see a good traction towards again 36,000. But again on the higher side, 36,000 will be a make or break level. One can say 36,000 will be a make or break level. Once we sustain about 36,000, then we may see the extension in the existing uptrend. If we fail to sustain about 36,000, then we may see some sort of consolidation in the range of 36,000 on the higher side and 35,000 on the downside. So 1,200 points consolidation we may witness in the Nifty Bank. But like I said, once we sustain about 36,000, the structure will be quite positive, and we may head towards 36,500 on the immediate basis and 37,000-38,000 on the overall basis. So these are the level that one need to keep a radar on for the Nifty Bank. Now let's look at the sector. As such, the wow factor is not have been seen in the particular sectors, but again the housing finance companies, which has been showed a very good traction in the last week, can be focused because it has given the fantastic breakout on the bigger time frame. Now if you can ask me what are the stocks, let's discuss the housing finance stocks. First name that come to my radar is the Indiabulls Housing Finance. If you look at on the weekly chart, I'm totally looking these charts on the longer time frame, because it has given the massive breakouts. When I say massive breakout, it stand for 6 months to year. It is not the trading bet that one need to keep a radar on. One can look for the investment perspective also with a horizon time frame of the 6 months to the 1 year perspective. On any dips will be again buying opportunity in these stocks, because the breakouts was very neat and clean. So first stock is the Indiabulls Housing Finance, and look at the breakout and look at the volume also. The neat and clean breakout has been witnessed about 245 zone. It managed to close the week about the breakout zone, which means that any dips will near 245, 240 zone will be again buying opportunity, and we may see the next leg of move towards 330 odd level, because as such there is no strong hurdle below 330 zone. So we may see the next leg of move in India IBUL Housing Finance towards 330, but again dips will be suggested. Those who are holding IndiaBull Housing Finance, definitely they can hold, so with keeping stop loss below 240 on closing basis on the positional perspective. Again, I'm saying this is not the trading bet. One need to look for the positional way, because the breakout is on the weekly chart, not on the daily chart or on the, one can say, the on the hourly chart and all. But sorry, breakout is very neat and clean. The second stock again which is on my radar is the LIC Housing Finance from the same space, one can say. Just a minute. Yeah, so again same chart has been seen. Now again these stocks, LIC Housing Finance has given the, you know, inverted head and shoulder breakout. I will draw just a minute. So this is the inverted head and shoulder breakout, one can say, in the LIC Housing Finance. Strong volume has been witnessed. Okay, so this is the inverted head and shoulder pattern has been seen in the LIC Housing Finance. Breakout has been seen. Now the immediate hurdle for the LIC Housing Finance is this, okay, 580, 570 would be a strong hurdle zone. Again, this is the positional bet. Dips will be suggested. Don't try to enter at the current level, because again the prices has been moved quickly. So again dips will be suggested. Now if you can ask me where are the supports lies, the support zone is coming between 500 to 480. That would be the accumulating level, one can say. 500 to 480, that would be the accumulating zone. And the stop loss for this particular bet would be somewhere around below 450 odd levels on closing basis. Now, LIC Housing Finance, I have already drawn the immediate hurdle zone, which is the 580, where we may see good traction, because historically also we have been witnessed that from 580, 570 odd levels, we have been witnessed the profit booking. So smooth rally can be seen towards 580 odd level. So LIC Housing Finance would be my second housing stock that one need to keep a radar on for the positional perspective. Another pick that is on my radar is the Repco Home. Again, it's on the verge of breakout, one can say. It's on the verge of breakout. Now look at, this is the breakout zone. Okay, it has given the breakout, one can say the pain and breakout or the flag breakout, again the monthly chart, and look at the volume activity. So I think, you know, housing finance company has been seen a very good traction last week, and we may see more traction going forward. But again, like I said, one need to look at on the positional perspective. Now if you can see on the Repco form, 100 rupees upside can be seen, you know, 370 would be the next hurdle for the Repco home. But again the conditional applies here, 387 will be immediate hurdle. Okay, what is the high? Once we cross above the, you know, last week high, then we may see a very good traction. Now what are the supports for the Repco home? So 340 is the immediate and the strong support zone for the Repco home. Again, another positional pick that if someone is looking for the housing finance company, yes, these are the three picks: LIC Housing Finance, IndiaBull Housing Finance, and the Repco home. One need to keep a radar on. Now the another stock, like I said, the not much traction has been seen in the, you know, sector specific, but still somehow I try to find out the some, you know, the one can say the production in the breakout, if you can see in the Nifty Metal. Just a minute. So again, Nifty Metal has been seen the very good traction. Again, last week has been seen that there is small breakout from the rounding bottom sort of pattern on the hourly chart, you know, and the, you know, prices again moving towards the northward. So I think until unless it is trading above 5000 odd level, the structure is quite positive. Again, any dips will be suggested in the metal space is, looks good for the, again, investment positional perspective, not for the, you know, immediate trading perspective one can take. But again, one need to follow the stop loss rigorously. So I think Nifty Metal will be the another space that one need to keep a radar on. Stocks in the particular space like SAIL, Tata Steel, JSW Steel, you can keep watch on the your watch list. We may see some more traction in the SAIL, Tata Steel, JSW Steel. Now let's look at the stock specific action. The first stocks came across to me is the Emami. Just a minute. Now if you can see in here, stock has been given a breakout. Just a minute. Stock has given a breakout from above its swing high. So this was the swing high for the, you know, Emami. It has taken decisively, and volume activity has been also seen. So I think until and unless, again, one, this is those who are holding stocks, I'm talking about them. Now, on the immediate basis, immediate support lies somewhere around 520 odd levels. So 520 will be the immediate stop loss for those who are holding Emami, and the final stop loss lies somewhere around this level, 495. If these levels are held, then we may see the next leg of move towards 600 odd levels. The another stock that I wanted to focus on is the Britannia. Just a minute. Again, if you can see on this weekly chart, okay, this is the strong breakout has been seen in the past, and now it will act as a strong demand zone, and again prices has taken the support on the weekly chart. This can be a very good demand zone for the Britannia. On if you go on the our daily chart, it has formed the bullish harami sort of candle pattern, which is again the bullish reversal candle pattern. So I think until unless Britannia is trading above 3370, the structure is quite positive, and we may see a good move towards 3800 in the long run. So I think again Britannia would be a positional pick that if someone is holding, they can keep their holding position intact with keeping stop loss below 3370. The another stocks which is on my radar is the NR Bearing. Let me show. I tried to look at on the broader picture. Again here, if you can see on the weekly chart, it has given the fantastic breakout, and look at the volume activity. Strong volume activity has been seen. You know, I tried to look the charts on the majority on the weekly chart, because as such, you know, we may see some dip in those stocks, and that would be a buying opportunity, not at current level again. So I think if you look at on the NR Bearings, 124, 125 is the fantastic support. You know, those who are holding, definitely they can hold, so with keeping stop loss below 124 on the closing basis, and we may see a good traction going forward in NR Bearing also. Okay, so this is the third stock, and the final stock that I which is on my radar for the next week is the Tata KEM. If you can see on the daily chart, again it has given the false breakdown. Okay, false breakdown was there, and again it backed in the demand zone, but again one need to be very skeptical at the moment. 750 will be immediate hurdle. Once we see a move above 750, then next hurdle somewhere around 790, 785 would be the next hurdle. So I think those who are holding Tata Chemical, definitely they can hold. So, but again, like I said, 750 will be a make or break level. Once we see a move above 750, then there would be no as such hurdle below 790. So next move can be witnessed towards 790. Now, what will be the stop loss for those who are holding? So I think on the immediate basis, your stop loss somewhere coming around 725 on closing basis, and the overall basis it is somewhere around 710. So one need to be again follow the rigorously stop losses. So I think that's all from our side. We have discussed the Nifty Bank Housing Finance Company, which has seen a good boom in the last week, and Nifty Metal that may see some traction in coming week. Stock also we have discussed Britannia, Emami, NRB and Tata Chemical. So thank you so much for watching this. Stay safe. Thank you so much.